It was too gruesome to watch.
I didn't want to see anymore, so I ran in the house.
Bev Golob had been sitting on the swing in her front yard when she saw it happen.
Two all-terrain vehicles were racing. They were coming from the west and headed east out here on Lyon Street, and I heard the high rate of speed they were coming.
That's when she says she saw them run the stop sign. One collided with a southbound car and then a northbound car.
She said that she thought it was the body flipped over the car.
A 29-year-old landing on the concrete. Horrific, but not a surprise.
And they do it all the time. They look around, no lights on the vehicles, and they just go on ripping down that street. Very common to go down that street.
They're made to not be on the street, they're made to be on off-road.
DNR officers and police get complaints every day, especially from that neighborhood, where people say ATVs speed in the shadows.
I'd guess 40, 50, 60 mile an hour, just as fast as they can get them going.
And there's lots of these race quads coming out that, you know, some of them do have a lot of power and do go fairly fast.
On private property or designated parks, they're legal and fun. DNR safety courses ensure riders are safe too. But last night's aftermath illustrates why ATVs like this one, without lights, aren't allowed on most city streets.
They're totally different than a car. You know, they don't have all the crumple zones, they don't have all that stuff for safety. They're designed to be an off-road machine.